Good morning, all of you.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah. So, today we are going to see something interesting. What is this? Robotics. What is robotics?
Subject.
It's a subject. Okay, fine. Any other? Robotics. Yes?
It's made to perform a certain task.
It's made to perform a certain task. Nice. So here we are starting session. I'll tell you the agenda. So for first 50 to 60 minutes, we are going through this PowerPoint presentation. What is there inside this PowerPoint presentation? Whatever the knowledge we are required for our practical purpose, all the things are present in this PowerPoint. So please cooperate. If you skip any part of this, you won't understand the concept. Fair enough? Yes, fair enough?
Yes, sir.
If you have doubt at any point, just raise your hand or call me. I will be there to solve your doubt. Fair enough?
Yes, sir.
Shall we start now?
Yes, sir.
Sure?
Yes,
sir. So the very first, the question is, what is robotics? Have you seen any robot?
Yes, sir.
Where? In robot movie. Chitti robot. Okay. So now tell me the definition of robot. Like you study each and every concept, no? There is definition for each word. So we know the definition of robot. So you are working like machine now. You are not using your brain. You are just copying this. Basically, it's a non-living thing. So, what is the standard definition of this? Yeah, good. Any other one to say about this? Yes. Pay attention. Yeah. It makes our work easy. Any other answers? Yeah. So now it's the standard definition. Yes. You go here. A machine that is capable of carrying out a complex series of actions automatically is specially run by programmable devices like computers or whatever it is. So what is the meaning of capable of carrying out complex series of actions? It is only perform one action or one task? No, it made for doing multi-purpose tasks, na? It's a multi-task device, na? So a machine capable of carrying out a complex series of actions automatically. How it works automatically? Because we already told that machine what to do next by using which language? Arduino or any other programming language. So, getting this point? So what is the report? It's a machine that capable of carrying out a complex series of actions automatically, especially when programmable by computer. Any doubt in this? Next point is, what are the applications of robotics? To help in daily life, okay. I want some proper applications. Surgical? Surgical robots, okay, yes.
How about drones?
Medical industries, drones. Space exploration, very good. Artificial intelligence is a technology, not an application. Industries, in which industries? Almost in all industries? Yes? Almost in all industries? Yes, now the next question is, do you have any robot at your home? Yes? Any other? We have a friend who? We have? CPU. No, this is not a robot. Yes! Anybody have robot? First group? No? This? This? Washing machine. Yes! This is a very simple example. Microwave. What is a washing machine? Yes, guys, last boys, please pay attention. What is a washing machine? How it works? The machine is already programmed. You just need to press buttons, na? Rest of the task, machine will do automatically. So this is also an example of robot. So anything which uses automation or work on automation, we can say it as a what word? Robot. So robot is nothing but an automation. So these are some main applications of robots: industry, medical, military, space exploration, research and development. Now we'll talk about what are the advantages of robotics or automation. Makes our life easy or lazy?
Lazy,
yeah. Work output is fast, no human errors, yes. Reduces human intervention, yes. Any other? No need to? Speed up? Robot, okay. Yes, yes, yes. What are the advantages of robotic system or automation? Very simple question. You can turn your chairs like this. It's yours, you can turn your chairs like this.
No, we need to feed a robot.
We need to
feed a robot.
Feed a robot? Electricity, yeah. See, someone said we don't need to feed a robot. Who's stand up. You also stand up. What was your statement about robotics? Advantages?
Much more cost to give
energy to a human than to a robot.
What about you?
Electricity is needed for a robot to run, so it is there
for
crops are much more cost. Your statement was you don't need to feed, your statement was it was
economical. Yes, yes, now I will tell you who is correct. Yes, who is correct? He or that? This guy or that? Whenever we are using machine, what is the requirement? Electricity. But your machine can work, guys, pay attention, but your machine can work 24/7, isn't it? With same accuracy? Yes or no? But can human work 24/7 with same accuracy? We need to feed human like food. But in the same manner, again, we need to build electricity or any other energies to robot. So both points are valid, but as compared humans with robots, which is more preferable?
Robots.
Why? They have some more advantages than manual systems. So this is a picture where robots are picking some muffins or cakes from one side and placing to another side. How soft it is? Very soft. So we need very much precision and accuracy over there. So this robot has that much of precision and accuracy. So that's why we are using robots in almost 99% industries. Isn't it? Coke industry, have you ever seen Coke industry? Then you have car manufacturing unit, car painting, then welding, etc. etc. is there, na? Yes or no? Any other application you want to discuss? Okay. Tell me the application of robots in military. Yes, one by one. I'll ask you, yes, first group.
Infiltrating bases.
Okay, second? Surveillance. Good. Third? Fourth? Yes, you guys. Pick it out. Drone, yes. Finding?
Finding a landmine.
This is a very useful thing, na? Finding a exposure things like landmines, bombs, isn't it? So suppose one human is there to find this bomb and defuse this bomb. So it is a danger, na? So your robot can replace this work. So this is the advantage of robotics in military. Next, yeah.
Relief purposes, relief as well.
Yeah, right. And one of
violence without risk.
The help is communication. Okay, fair enough. So the of course you see that was that Uri movie. What was there in that movie? Garud is there, na? What was that Garud? Yes, pay attention guys. It's one kind of drone. And drone designed as a bird. And all what? Yes, cattle is girl. What are you doing?
Ask me.
Yes, stand up and tell you everything.
Check mic.
Yes, listen to it now.
So it's a drone. It was sent to identify all the enemies in the Pakistan occupied Kashmir, and it was designed as a bird so that no one understands that it's a drone and it's kept for spying on them. So it was a strategy too.
Disadvantage. Everything has some advantages as well as some disadvantages. Yes, that is it. Right answer. Stand up and tell everyone.
It makes us lazy.
It makes our life very easy. That's why we become very lazy. So this is the main disadvantage, na? Yes. It increases unemployment, right? But you make this kind of proposal. Yes. So apart from this, till now, we have discussed well what are the applications of robot, what is the definition of robot, and now we'll move towards types of robots. Do you have notebooks with you? Yes? Just note it down. I'll explain you. Yes. So there are basic three types of robots. What are those? Manual, semi-automatic, automatic, or autonomous, or semi-autonomous. You can call it both. What is a manual? Remote control. That means it always requires human intervention. Yes. Second is semi-autonomous. What is semi-autonomous or semi-automatic? Exactly. It can work as both, but sometimes it requires human intervention. Right? What about third, autonomous? It doesn't require human intervention. Right? So now, tell me an example of manual and semi-automatic robot. Or semi-automatic robot and yes. So we are seeing two types of washing machines. And here we use which one? Semi-autonomous washing machine and semi-automatic. And now a days we are using which one? Automatic washing machine. So what is the difference in that? Yeah.
In semi-automatic washing machine, you have to give manual input. But in automatic washing machine, it senses on its own and it starts functioning.
There are two compartments, no? In semi-automatic washing machines. One is for washing, another is for drying. So after completion of washing procedure, you have to put this into another compartment. But what about your autonomous washing machine? You just have to press that start button. As soon as you press start button, it will automatically calculate the weight of your clothes. Accordingly, takes amount of water, automatically washes, dries, everything is automatic. So this is the difference in between semi-automatic and automatic. Now what about, again in manual, there are two subtypes. What are those?
Wired
and yes, please stand up. Where are you lagging? Now it's your second time. Then? Last one. Yes. Wired and? Wireless. Tell me any example of wired and wireless things.
Wireless.
What is the technology behind it? What is that? How to convert wired things into a wireless? Yeah, one option is Bluetooth. IoT, infrared, Wi-Fi. The main thing is transmitter and receiver end you require. Like transmitter is inserted in this pipe, so it's transmitting signal, and receiver is over there in that amplifier machine. So like this, we are communicating. Same, you have that receiver module like USB module for your mouse. You have to insert it, na? Otherwise it will work or no? It won't work, na? Until unless you are putting that. So, how to make wired thing into wireless? You require something to transmit and another thing to receive. What about pre-programmed? It is structure already totally programmed. What about self-learning? It's a part of AI and machine learning. Machine will automatically learn according to previous experiences. Now we'll proceed towards microcontroller. What is microcontroller? Do you know about it? Yes, what is microcontroller? It's a small chip. We can say it's a brain of robot, because this is the decision making device inside the robot. And suppose we are doing programming, where we are storing this program? Inside the memory of microcontroller. So we can say microcontroller is the brain of any robotics system. What is sensor? Sensor. Basically, the device which gives us environmental information like temperature, humidity, etc. There are n numbers of parameters. The device which gives us certain information, that device we can call it as sensors. What is actuator? Have you heard about actuator? Okay. Yes, actuator. Actuator is a one kind of motor which converts one kind of energy into a mechanical energy. Like a device which convert electrical energy into a which energy? Meaningful mechanical word. Any example? Think on it, any examples?
Motor.
DC motor. Fan is on there. Fan is there. What about fan? We are giving electrical supply, but what we are getting? A rotational movement.
Yes, yes.
This is a mechanical movement, isn't it? So this is the one kind of actuator. So we can say motors are actuator. Fair enough? Yes. If you don't want to say it, go outside. But don't cut the class. This girl and all of you, this 5 words. Or else come and sit front side. I am observing you from last 10 to 15 minutes. What about you? Yes. Really telling you, if you don't have any interest in this now, don't sit over here. Because you are disturbing all this guys. Yes. Fair enough this. Any doubts? What is sensor? What is sensor? It senses environmental conditions. Sensors gives us information about environmental conditions. Examples?
Temperature,
obstacles, humidity. So there are 8 numbers of sensors available in market. More than 500, 600 sensors are there. What about actuator? What is actuator? Yeah, the device which converts electrical energy into a meaningful mechanical work. We can say that device is motor. Fair enough? So how many sensors we have inside our body? Many? How many? Right. How many basic sensors we have inside our body? Five. What are those? First is eyes, nose, tongue and skin. They are giving us information about, eyes is giving information about visionary, hearing purpose, smelling purpose, taste purpose and touch. So like robots have some sensors, we also have some sensors inside our body. Does we have microcontroller inside our body? How many of you have microcontroller inside your body? Raise your hands. So rest of the people, you don't have breath? Yes, you have. Huh? I told you one statement. Microcontroller is the brain of the robots. So robots also have some sensors. Like we also have brain. So we can call it as a microcontroller of our body. Isn't it? Because this is a decision making. Huh? The brain is only a decision making device inside our body. And what about actuators? Do we have any actuator inside our body? Yes, muscles, hands, legs, joints. Yes. So we also have some sensors inside our body, actuators inside our body, as well as microcontroller inside our body. So now I'll tell you an example how this system work or how it's more accurate than others. Why sensors are useful? We'll take a daily life example. All of you know how to ride a bike or a cycle. Just an example. Yeah. So these sensors you used when you are riding cycle or bike. Eyes and basic things we need required as a sensors. Then for controlling, which actuator you have used? Legs and hand muscles. And you also have microcontrollers inside your body. So suppose there is a board of this. Return on, there is speed limitation of 100 kmph. What is the speed limitation?
100
kmph. And now how many sensors we are using? Eyes, ears, brain as a microcontroller, and actuators as our hand muscles and legs. So now tell me, suppose your speed is increasing, but what program is stored inside your brain now? Speed is
100.
But now speed is beyond 100, nearly 110 or 120. What will happen? How? Tell me the procedure. Tell me the procedure of sensors to actuator. Yes, anyone. Yes, pay attention.
First of all, I will sense.
So first of all, we use sensors, then next?
Then the message goes to our microcontroller,
that is our brain. So the second component which comes inside the picture is microcontroller, which is decision making device. What about next?
And it sends the message to slow down to the...
First of all, it will compare that signal with pre-stored signal. What is pre-stored? 100 kmph. So suppose speed is 110, then it's more than 100, then it will send commands to your hand muscles and leg muscles to slow down your speed. Fair enough? In the same manner, robotic system works. It has some sensors, so those sensors send instructions to microcontroller. We have already programmed that microcontroller to work on particular things. Like suppose sensor input is this, then you have to do this. Fair enough? Suppose sensor input is A, I'll give you just example. Suppose sensor input is A, you have to go forward. Suppose sensor input is B, you have to come backward. Like this, it depends upon you. You can swap it. If suppose sensor input is A, you can come backward. You are a programmer, na? You are giving instructions. So these are totally depend on ourselves. What program we are writing? Fair enough?
Yes.
Yes, everybody? Fair enough?
Yes, sir.
So all of you have Arduino installed into your systems?
Yes, sir.
Now first of all, we'll see the pin configuration of Arduino board. What is the meaning of pin configuration? There are some naming or tags for each pin which is present on Arduino board. So this is the board which we are going to use. So this board is known as, this is the latest board of Arduino. We can call it as Arduino Nano. There are more than 10 models of Arduino. Arduino LiliPad, Arduino Uno, Arduino Mega, so many models are there. Arduino Micro. What's the advantage of this board? Yes,
let's go back.
What is the advantage of this board? This boat is smaller in size, firstly, but has more inputs and outputs than Arduino Uno. This is based on nanotechnology. The name of this board is Arduino Nano. This is a very latest board of Arduino. So first of all, you have to understand concept of digital signal and analog signal. Do you know about it? What is digital signal? What is analog signal? Yes? Yes? Anybody? Yes? Where is another mic?
Analog signals are used in telephone lines and digital signals are used in our devices.
Okay, yes, but do you know what is the main difference in analog and digital signal? It's a very important to know this point. So, I'll tell you, yes, pay attention guys. This is the most important thing when you are dealing with any kind of system. What is analog signal? Analog signal has continuous value. Suppose we are taking a range of 0 to 100. Yes, we are taking range of 0 to 100. So it will shows you value in between 0 to 100 also, like 10, 20, 23, up to 100. But what about digital signal? That means it only has two states. Either it will show you 0 or directly 100. Either it will show you 0 or directly. Fair enough, any doubts in analog and digital? Yes, raise your hands. I'll give you some other example. Analog and digital. So what is analog? Analog sensor or analog signal will give us a values in a continuous manner, like this graph. So what we are taking, we have taken the example of 0 to 100. Huh? So if suppose we have a range of 0 to 100, it will show, we'll take an example of simple your water tank. The capacity of water tank is 0% to 100%. So your sensor will show you your water tank is 10% full, 12% full, any value in between 0 to 100. But suppose you are using digital sensors, then it will only shows you either your tank is 0% or at, it won't shows you middle values. So it has only two states, either 0 or 1. What's the meaning of the 0? Is 0 volts. What is the meaning of 1? Is 5 volts. Note it down. I'll be able to note it down. 0 volt, 0 V. Meaning of volt is voltage. Yeah, fair enough. So 0 volt is equals to ground. Ground. The short form of ground is GND. So write in the bracket, inside the bracket, GND. Meaning of GND is ground is equals to low, LOW. Low. Right? So the meaning of all these three words is same. You can either zero volt or ground or low. The meaning of all of these three words are same. Now, in the programming language, we only use low. This term from these three things, low. But what is the meaning of this low? Zero volt. So whenever we are providing 0 volt to our any system, will it works? Will it works? No. Because for working of any electrical system, it requires power supply. That means some amount of voltage. All of you use your mobile phones? Yes. So inside that, battery is there. So battery rating is also there. 3.3 volt, 5 volt. So what is this volt? It's a power supply. Without that power supply, like not only your mobile phones, but any electrical device won't work. Fair enough. Now below that line, write down next things. 5 volt. 5 volt is equals to 1 is equals to high, H-I-G-H, high is equals to V in. What is the meaning of V in? Voltage in. Fair enough? V in is a short form used for voltage in. So this G and D, V in, Phi V is noted on there to your board. Yeah. 5 volt is equals to 1 is equals to high is equals to voltage in. Short form of voltage in is V in. Fair enough? Yes guys, fair enough, any doubt? Shall we proceed further? Once you got your boards, I'll explain you the pin diagram. So meanwhile, we'll start the concept of programming. Yes? All of you have opened your Arduino? Open your Arduino? Yes, listen guys. Programming is very easy. But you have to pay attention for a while. See. Certain commands are there, 4 to 5 commands are there. You have to remember that commands only. You have to repeat that. That's it. So it's a very easy, but you have to concentrate for a few minutes. I'm going to explain you about programming. Please cooperate. I'm present over there. What are those? Yes. First is void setup. Second is now first of all. First of all, understood the meaning of what is this void setup and when we use void setup and when we use void loop. What is the meaning of setup? Yes, last. Yes, what is the meaning of setup?
Run the code which is inside the function setup when the program starts, like at one time.
Okay, yeah, fine, right. Any other?
What's the meaning of setup?
Yes.
Sir, putting all the commands in the robot. The command.
Yes. So here, why we are using this void setup? Point configuring our pins. Point configuring our pins. Which pin we are using as an input and which pin we are using as a output. What is our input? Sensors. Sensors are input devices to your microcontroller. Because they are sending information to microcontroller. And what about output devices? Actuators, LED, whatever. To whom microcontroller is sending some instructions, we can call that device as a output device. And sensors are input device. Yes, repeat it. Sensors are input devices. Motors, LED, buzzers are output devices. So likewise this, now we are attaching all these sensors and motors to our microcontroller. Isn't it? So we know that on which pin we are connecting sensors and on which pin we are connecting motors, that means inputs and outputs. But how does your microcontroller know this? So, for understanding of your microcontroller, which pin we are using as an input and output, we use this void setup all thing. Okay, so there is one standard syntax to define pins as an input and output. I will show you what is that standard syntax. Yes, boys, please maintain the silence. Yes, man, last boy. Man, can you stand? So, I am showing you on notepad. You just have to write down same instructions into your Arduino. Clear enough? All of you have these things onto your Arduino board? Yes? Now, yes, can I check all of you? Yes, silence. Now, how to set up inputs and outputs. What is that command?
Hello everyone, listen. In your Arduino software, under file there is the option preferences. In the preferences, you can increase the size of font. By default, it's I think 12 and it is very too small to read. So everybody make it at least 18 to 20 so that you can see the things clearly on your screen.
All of you got kids? Yes? So there is one small board in this packet. This is your Arduino board. Open it up. The question one board. Let's see the pin configuration of this board. Some labeling is there. Remove it from this board. Some labeling is there in very small font. Yes. First we'll see the pin configuration of our Arduino board. Then we'll start with this thing. So there are some labeling. D2, D3. Are you able to write it out?
Yes, sir.
All of you? D2, D3, D4, D5, D6. Onto your Arduino board. Check out your Arduino board. I have so much of stuff to show you. I have a dancing robot, I have a drone, but if you are behaving like this only, if you are not cooperating with me, it won't be possible in this kind of small time. So please maintain a silence. Yes. So all of you able to find out those pins? D2, D3, D4, D5.
Yes, sir.
Some other pins are there. A0, A1, A2. Is it? Is it there? What is the meaning of that pins? Yes. A means analog. It means digital. Some other pins are there. GND.
Ground.
E, voltage E, 5V, it provides you 5V. Understand these things? Now, this is our inputs and output pins. D0 to D13. Total how many digital pins we have? 14. And A0 to A7? 8. So 14 plus 8? 22. So we can connect up to 22 sensors, that means inputs and outputs to this much of small board. Isn't it very interesting? So now, we'll proceed towards programming. Yes guys, now I want really like pin drop silence. Pay attention over here. It's a very crucial point. Commands. What are those commands? So how to set up inputs and outputs? D0 and D1 are considered as TX and RX. D0 and D1 pin are labeled as TX and RX on your Arduino board. Yes. What is this syntax is all about? Now what we are doing? Don't connect anything. Remove your all circuits. Don't connect anything. Go step by step. If any component is damaged, we are not going to replace it. So please don't do anything by your own. So what is this instruction? pin board into a bracket 13 comma output. 13 means B13. You don't have to mention D over here for digital pins. It will automatically recognize that 13 means D13. But in the case of analog sensors, we have to write A before you are writing 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever it is. Fair enough? Now understand the meaning of this command. Pin mode. Pin means 13. This pin 13. And mode is output. So pin mode 13 comma output is assigning our 13 number pin behave as a output. Fair enough? So you can connect LED over here, buzzer or actuator, that is your motor. Fine. Suppose now I want to take input. That means I want to connect some sensors. Then what is the condition? Pin mode 2, input. Yes, right. Make sure while you are writing this command, M is capital. Pin mode M is capital. And then again 13 comma output or input. This statement is in uppercase. That means in a capital letters. Fair enough? Any doubts in this command? This is a very basic command for each and every program. Like if you want to program it for very high end, you have to write down this command first. It's a very basic command. So whenever we are going to connect sensors, that means inputs and outputs, first we have to define it into a void setup. So if it's an input, then pin mode means pin. Pin number is 13, mode is output. Pin mode 2 comma input. So you can connect sensor over there. Whenever you are writing or getting digital pins, at that time there is no need of writing any prefix like D. But whenever you are using analog pins, you have to write prefix A. Capital A, A0, only A7, A0, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7. When do we use analog and when do we use digital? Anyone have answer for this? When we use analog, when we use digital? Yes, pay attention. When analog is required, when we are capturing or measuring temperature. When we are capturing or measuring temperature. Temperature is analog value or digital value? It's analog value. It's variable, no? It's giving us continuous values. But suppose now we are measuring an obstructor. Like suppose someone is there or not. Either yes or no. Is there any other statement? Or any other condition? I have true or false. So at this moment we use this sensor, digital sensor. So you have a digital, you have two digital sensors with you, this package. These are IR sensors, infrared sensors. Open this package and I'll tell you the principle behind it. Open up that packet, IR sensor, remove your IR sensor. If you want, you can open both. Yes, done. There are two LEDs, isn't it? Yes. two LEDs. What is the use of those two LEDs? Do you know the concept of LED? Light emitting diode. What about photodiode? Have you heard about photodiode? Photodiode absorbs the light. LED is emitting the light, photodiode is absorb the light. So it will work as transmitter as well as receiver. Fair enough? Yes? Transmission as well as receiver. So now we take one example of obstructor. Okay? Suppose LED is emitting the light and one obstacle is present. So what will happen? Bouncing back of light, then your photodiode will receive that light and send signal, someone is there. Yes? Right? When there is nobody is there standing out of in front of your sensor, what will happen? No reflection of light. Fine? So your receiver sensor is not receiving anything. So at that time your output is a low. Nothing is there. Fair enough? Getting or not? Yes? So we have to use these sensors in today's workshop. So this is all about when you are using like initializing inputs and outputs. Now the next step. How to give instructions to output devices. So what is the meaning of semicolon? That semicolon is very important. Aim that particular statement. Understood this thing? Then listen to me. Whenever you are writing any statement, not a condition. Conditions are like if, else, do, while. These conditions are not required, this kind of semicolons. But statements like this, what we have written, the right giving, all these statements require semicolon after each end of the statement. Now I forget to give there. I'll tell you one more thing. On back side of your Arduino, four white dots are there. Yes. Check over here. On back side of your Arduino, four white dots are there, isn't it? Yes? Some labels are there now. Rx, Tx, PWR and L. Isn't it? Are you getting it or not? Yes? All of you got those four LEDs? What that name means, PWR? Power. Yes? On your Arduino, from your Arduino, so what is the meaning of PWR? Power. So whenever we are giving power to our Arduino, that LED will automatically turn on. What is the meaning of TX and RX? I told you already. D1 and D0. That means transmission and reception. When transmission and reception operation is going on, this 2 LED will be turned on. What about that L? L is there, na? So that L LED is internally connected to pin number D13. Which pin? So whenever you write program for D13, automatically this L LED gets affected. Fair enough? So now tell me, what is the output of this program? Yes, anybody? Yes? Yes, this is it.
It will send a signal of 1 to the 13th bit and will delay for 1000 bits. It will delay for 1000 milliseconds.
Yeah, exactly right.
It will delay for 1 second and then after that, this is right, it's the same thing. It will send 0 signal to the 13th bit and then the same thing.
But what is the output we are getting? Exactly. Blinking of LED. Which LED? That LED, which is present onto your Arduino board. Fair enough? So when all of you downloaded that folder CH340, it was there only. CH340. Open that folder. Another folder was there, CH340. Yeah, right. Unzip this. Yes, he said, that is over here. Whenever you are installing drivers into your system, yes, important notification is there. Whenever you are installing driver to your systems, make sure your Arduino is connected to your system with USB cable. Until and unless your Arduino is not connected with your system, driver won't install. Right? That is your buzzer. The longer it is positively, the shorter it is negatively. So you have to connect negatively at GND point, that is ground point, and longer lead at D13 or D12, whatever you are mentioning as an output. Yes, patient. One small blacker device is there that is known as your buzzer. The longer lead is positively, the shorter lead is negatively. So the negative lead should be connected at this point in Arduino, G and D, that is ground. What about longer lead? Output of Arduino. In our case, you have taken D13 as output. So you can connect that pin at D13, or else you can change it. Connect one wire to positive node, another to negative node, then accordingly the second point of wire goes to Arduino. One is at GND, negative to GND, positive to D13. Yes, one group got the output. For rest of the people, I am showing you. Yes! Maintain silence. How to connect buzzer, I'm going to show you. Negative node of, that is smaller node of your buzzer, goes to GND, that is ground pin of your Arduino. And longer lead at pin number D13. Turn off your buzzers, remove your Arduino from your systems. Remove your Arduino from your systems. Yes, one announcement is there. Yes, please be serious.
want 10 to 15 minutes break or you want to continue the session? Yes, we can continue, but I'm also feeling very hungry. So we'll take, yes, listen, we'll take only 10 minutes break. After that, we are about to start building the robot. So don't be late, come back in 10 minutes. Yes, one more thing. The great responsibility is totally up to all you. So, take a precaution of your kids. Yes, there are three types of screws are available with you. Yes, three types of screws are there. One is very small and pointed screw. Yes, in a quantity of two. Yes, I want pin drop silence. Otherwise, I'm not going to tell you anything. Yes, guys, pay attention. Meanwhile, we are providing another set of screws. How to fix it? Place the motor like this, then match the holes from outside and place the screws from outside only, not from inside.
Everybody listen now. If you have any problem in understanding the instructions, you just raise hand. Okay, in that. Okay. So ma'am or sir will go to you to sort it out.
Understood this? next? Yes, first of all, understand this program. What is that? Now we are going to use one sensor. We are going to make obstacle avoider robot. Suppose obstacle is there, it will automatically change its direction or else goes to the backward side. Fine? So now we are using one sensor. Till now we have dealt with output devices only. But now onwards, we are going to connect an input device, that is sensor. Yes? So how to write a program for that? First, we have two motors. So how many outputs are required? Four. So we have initialized four outputs, 10 comma output, 11 comma output, 12 comma output, and 13 comma output. And again we have a sensor, that is IR sensor. We have already seen the principle of IR sensor. If suppose the obstacle comes in between, it will send the signal. So now we are going to connect that sensor on pin number D2. Which pin?
D2.
So statement will be pin mode 2 comma input. Pin mode 2 comma
input.
Write down the statement first. So the first is, for sensor we are taking which pin? We are taking which pin?
D2.
And for motors, for one motor, left motor we are taking 10-11. For right motor we are taking 12-13. Now take out your IR sensor. How many pins are there on your IR sensor? What are those? Some labelings are there, isn't it? Ground, VCC, and third pin is out. That means your data pin. You have to connect that pin to which pin number of Arduino? D2. Understand these things? And why we require positive and ground? For working of that sensor, supply is required. So we have to give positive and negative first. And the out pin, that is the data pin, will be connected at which pin of Arduino? Which pin of Arduino? D2. Right. Then up to this. I have written this 5 lines. First of all, remove your Arduino from your PC. If the Arduino connection is gone, then it will burn out. Remove your Arduino from this thing. Yes, get it over here. सबसे पहले क्या किया? एक variable लिया. INTS. S for sensor. S for you can take any variable, your name too. No, it's just a variable. Abhi ye variable kyu liya? Why do I take this variable? To store the value of sensor. To store the value of sensor. Isn't it? Sensor is giving us some values, na? And we have to store that value somewhere. So for storing that value, we have taken which variable? S variable. So first statement is INT, integer S. S is your variable. Then inside void setup, one input and how many outputs? Four outputs. Then up to this, any doubts in this? All of your doubts in this? Now the next part, how to read the data from sensor, how to use that data for further operations. Now we have these things in a void loop. Now inside void loop, what will be your first statement? Now the first statement will be reading the data from sensor. Reading the data from sensor. Yes? So what is the statement for that? What is the meaning of this statement? Till now, we have worked only one statement, that is digital write. Why? Because we are sending some instructions, we are writing some instructions, na? But now we are using sensors. So we have to read data from that sensor, isn't it? So what is the meaning of this statement? Digital signal. So read this statement. S is equals to digital read. Read digital signal from this pin D2. Why D2? Because we have already connected our sensor on which pin? D2. So read digital signal from pin D2 and store that data into which variable?
S.
But sir, understand?
Sir, S is a lowercase and it has been declared as key.
It's a case that said you. What you have written outside, same you have written over here. Fine. Any doubts in this? Last group. Any doubts in this? Please maintain the silence. What we have done till now, first we have taken one variable that is S. Then inside void loop, what we have done? What we have done inside void setup? We have set up inputs and outputs. Then inside the void loop, what is our first statement? Reading the digital signal from pin number D2 and store that into a variable S. Now what is the next step? What is the output of our this program or this application? What we are making? Obstacle over the robot. So suppose some obstacle is over there. What will be your output? If else conditions will be there. Like if your IR sensor output is there, then your robot should move in a which direction? Backward. That means obstacle is there, na? It should either turn left or go in a backward direction. Now how to do forward and backward direction? Make sure your both motors are moving in a forward direction for forward movement. Same as for backward movement. Both motors should be moving in a backward. How to take a left turn? The turn which you want to take, suppose you want to take a left turn, then either left will be stop or move in a backward direction, and another will be motor will be moving in a forward direction. Understood or not? If you want to take a left turn, then this wheel or this motor should be in a stop condition, and this will be in a forward direction. So it will take a left turn. Likewise this. So how to write an if-else condition? What we have done till now, we are done with reading the data. Now we are comparing that data with signal. When we use double is equals to, when we are comparing one value with another value, and signal is equals to for assigning the value. Like we used over there, na, S is equals to digital rate. So we are assigning D2's value to variable S. And in the next statement, S is equals to high. What's the meaning of high? 5 volt. So if suppose some person is there, so it will detect, and the output of I is also high. So the statement will be satisfied, condition is satisfied. It will enter into the loop and execute the statement. Now how to move motor into forward direction? Acting 10, like suppose motor has two terminals. Suppose on both terminals we give high, then what will happen? Motor will run or not? No, because there is no ground, only supply is there. In the same manner, if we give low, then again supply is not there. So the code for forward direction is high, low, and for backward is for stop either low or repeat it, for forward or reverse, for stop either or. Understood this concept? So same you have. Yes, next stage is how to connect to a sensor. After programming, how to connect to a sensor? Out pin will be connected on which pin? D2. Then GND will be connected to the GND pin of Arduino, and one more pin is there, na? VCC. You can connect VCC on 5V or VIN. 5V or VIN. Write down the program fast, then we'll execute. Yes, now the second part, the last part of your assembly, how to connect motors. All of you have this part. Yes, all of you have this part. This is the part which is connected in between. Yes, guys. Yes, get it over here. अगर आपकी समझ में नहीं आया तो किसी नहीं बताने वाला हूँ. 5 मिनट ध्यान दे तो बाद में आपका काम करके दो. So what is this? This device is called as motor driver device. As name suggests, is motor driver. Why we use this to driving the motors? So it has some inputs over here. 4 header pins are there. In 1, in 2, in 3, in 4. Check it out. A, B, C is there. A, B, C, D. It is there? Yes, first group, it is there now? A, B, C, D. Yeah. So you have to connect the output of Arduino to the input of this device. So what is the output of Arduino? 10, 11, 12, 13. So connect that 10, 11, 12, 13 over here. And at the opposite side, there are two ports, green color ports like this. Yes? It is written as motor 1 and motor 2. Motor 1 and motor 2. So the left motor will be going to connect on motor 1 and right motor will be going to connect at motor 2. Each motor has 2 wires, so each port has 2 slots. Connect it first. Don't connect your batteries.
Event was about Indian Army
inaugurated all the event, danced on patriotic songs. I have some video presentations over there, I will show you. Even we have one 6 feet tall humanoid robot. It will last long, if you use 24/7, it will last till 6 to 7 months.